Welcome to Harry Global, Mr. Satya ji. My first question to you will be, what led you to join the International Congress?
So basically, my whole family is a Congress family. And right from childhood, we have seen the Congress culture in our house and everywhere. So, of course, it was one of the important factors why I joined Congress Party and Students Movement in year 2000. But then gradually, when I started thinking and looking at political scenario worldwide, I realized that I have taken a right decision to win Congress Party.
Looking at the current scenario, like the increasing cases, every day the cases are increasing. So do you think there is a surge because of the communication gap between the government and the people?
There is a clear-cut, indeed, there is a communication gap between government and people, and at every level, I would say, not only at the state or central level, but even at a local level. But the most important factor is that Indian democracy is going through a different phase, I would say, that we are dependent on government for everything. And we blame government for everything and we demand from government everything, which is not correct, I would say. See, paying tax and demanding everything, rest everything from government is not a way of democracy. In democracy, everybody has to play their own role, which our people unfortunately are not paying. Today, if we see that COVID-19 numbers are increasing day by day, there was a phase where government was telling us to maintain distance and have COVID norms and COVID measures.
Right.
We unfortunately were not following it. We were having political programs of millions of people coming together. We were having functions. We were having family functions, parties, everything. You know, what not we did in last 6 months. You should just realize that whatever we have done in last 6 months, we are now paying for it.
There was the oxygen leak at Nashik and people lost, like 24 people have lost their lives. So what would you like to say about that?
See, it is an accident. We can't deny that. And that was a very unfortunate accident. Today, the situation is so panic that everybody is working under pressure. Right. And I'm sure that whoever was transferring that gas oxygen from the cylinder, from the tanker to the cylinder, must be under pressure and must have done some mistake, knowingly or unknowingly, which created a gas leakage, you know, oxygen leakage.
Right.
Because there was oxygen leakage and there is already a shortage of oxygen in market, somebody who was also responsible for this oxygen supply must have thought that already if there is a shortage of gas, a shortage of oxygen and leakage is going on. So he tried to switch off the complete oxygen supply. And due to that, 22 people unfortunately died into it. I would say that it is unfortunate incident. Those who are guilty into it should be taken in account and there should be a strict punishment to them. But on another side, we should also realize that everybody in this system today is working under tremendous pressure. We should also consider that.
And Mr. Manmohan Singh had written a letter to Mr. PM Modi about some recommendations related to vaccination. But, you know, they were not taken seriously earlier. So what would you like to comment on that?
Dr. Manmohan Singh is one of the God's gift for this country, I would say. You know, in 1991, when country was going through a tremendous economic crisis, when we had to mortgage our gold to get some payments from international banks, Dr. Manmohan Singh came as a God gift to us, like as an finance minister of country. He then revived the complete economy, and he is considered to be an honest, visionary, intellectual individual in this country. So whenever he writes something, first of all, though, I would rather say that this government is completely arrogant, and this government doesn't want to listen to anyone. They feel that they know everything, but unfortunately, they don't know anything. When you don't know anything, and when there is a crisis, there is no harm in going to an intellectual person like Dr. Manmohan Singh and ask for and seek for an advice, which they did not do. But when on his own, he wrote a letter to Prime Minister, he, rather than Prime Minister responding to him, one junior minister jumps into the conversation and writes a letter, and such a arrogant language, I would say, that had this not been a pandemic, we would have taken his case. But because there is a pandemic and our priorities are different, and we don't want to divert from those priorities. Otherwise, you know, this letter is completely arrogant letter written to such a highly qualified and high standards person like Dr. Manmohan Singh.
Right. So, so also I want to know, like, since there is a shortage of vaccine right now, there are many people who took their first dose, like people who are above the age of 45, and they are missing out on their second dose. So what would you like to say about this situation? Like, how can we handle
this? This is very unfortunate situation. Again, I would say that our leader, Rahul Gandhi, was for last 1 year saying that there should be a proper vaccine program strategy in a place where there will be a proper distribution channel, proper strategy in place, and vaccine for all was our demand from day one. This government did not listen to Mr. Rahul Gandhi. They started their abstractly, they started this vaccination program. They only gave permission to two vaccines, whereas they could have given permission to all other international vaccines, proven vaccines. They did not do that. They gave it to Covishield and Covaxin, which had very limited production capacity. Now today, people are not able to get the second dose. If they go to vaccine centers, there is a board, the vaccine is out of stock. So I think now, and into that, addition to this problem, now they have started vaccine for everyone from 1st of May.
Yes.
I'm sure that there is going to be tremendous shortage of vaccine after 1st of May. Those who are deserving people will not get vaccine. I'm sure about it. And hence, today morning only, I've tweeted that Narendra Modi, our Prime Minister, should immediately talk to Joe Biden, President of United States, and ask for an help, because US has millions of unused vaccines with them. And if we ask for a help, I'm sure they will help us, and the issue can be sorted out.
Right. So you don't think, like, the vaccination drive that they're starting from May 1st is going to help the situation? Is going to worsen?
It will worsen the situation. People will go to vaccine centers. They won't get vaccines. It will come into the open market because of shortage, and there is and no synchronization between demand and supply. There will be black market of these vaccines. People will, pharmaceutical companies and pharmacies and everyone will charge extra, and they will sell, and people will buy it, and this is going to happen. Whatever is happening with remdesivir, other injections, similarly will happen with vaccines after 1st of May if we don't have a proper policy in place.
Right. So this is for the citizens. I would like to ask, if you like to advise the citizens in the current situation?
I would say that only you can help yourself, and nobody else can help yourself. I have seen people who are billionaires and millionaires. They are super rich people, but they are crying for hospital beds today. So it is not for poor who are suffered. It is also ultra rich people who have tremendous money, but they can't afford to have a bed because there are no beds available. They are not able to get injections because injections are not available. Situation is very bad. Our healthcare system has completely collapsed. And hence, I would only suggest everyone to stay at home. Only you and you can take care of your family. Please stay at home. Please be safe. Keep safe distance. There is nothing more important than your health. Survival is the most important thing which we should focus on now.
Right. Thank you so much for your kind words, sir. I hope everyone takes your advice seriously and people stay calm in the situation.